This week, we're gonna show you how to disappear from the digital world and become a specter online. Or at least keep you from ever having to explain your search history to your mama. And let's get started with this first question. I barely use Facebook anymore. Should I just delete it? If you're not using that old account and you have no plans to start using it again, then it might be time to hit that old delete button. Adios! Keeping an inactive account just adds to an ever-increasing pile of digital clutter and opens you up to targeted advertisements based on your old profiles. But hitting that delete button ain't always easy. First thing you gotta do is log into that dusty old Facebook account, and if you don't remember the password, that sucks for you. Once you're in, follow along close with me because it's about to get real confusing up in here. First, hit the menu button on the bottom right, just under your cute little face. Then, do a big, big old scroll to settings, and under the account block, tap personal and account information. Then, account ownership and control. Now hit deactivation and deletion. Select delete account, not deactivate, which by the way doesn't do jack diddly squat, except lets Facebook hold onto your precious data. Keep hitting continue until poof, she's gone. But what about your profile? Are all those cringy high school pics still floating around out there somewhere like a tornado of embarrassment? Good news, they're gone. Along with all other photos, posts, and anything else you uploaded or posted on your profile. So we threw out the dinosaur that's been tracking us for decades, but how about a new platform like TikTok? Maybe you were pressured into making an account by an ex, or you just wanted to watch one of those puppy videos and didn't realize how much TikTok would be tracking your online activity. TikTok is known for having a pretty aggressive data harvesting strategy. Creepy. So yeah, it's totally fine to want off this boat, and it's actually easier than some of the other services out there. First, go to your profile on the bottom right and look for that little hamburger icon on the top right. Tap that burger, and under the account settings, hit deactivate or delete. Those are just a couple of heavy hitters, but you might have a bunch of old accounts you might want to get rid of. Maybe there are some weirder ones out there you want to get off. I've got to get rid of my Friendster, my Dogster, my MySpace, and my LiveJournal. Next! What else can I do to protect my privacy if I don't want to delete any accounts? When it comes to your overall online privacy, your choice of web browser can make all the difference. Just think of all the creepy third-party trackers lurking on the web, waiting to collect your data like a bunch of digital vampires. Those digital bloodsuckers have one main way of tracking your online activity. Cookies! Stock browsers like Edge and Chrome don't offer the best protection against third-party cookies. Firefox, on the other hand, is the most private and secure major browser available, and the only one with total cookie protection by default, which keeps cookies contained and secure so companies can't track you between websites. Plus, it's easier than ever to migrate off your old stinky browser to a shiny new Firefox installation. Step one, which should also be the first step you follow every time you buy a new computer, download and install Firefox. The first time you open Firefox, it should ask you if you want to import settings and data from Safari or Chrome. Just like that. It'll even do your stored passwords. That's it. Super painless, right? But what if you want to go deeper? Yes, Firefox has a feature for that. Take a look at private browsing on Firefox desktop. It's a lot like incognito mode in Chrome, except it's wicked fast and built on the same security backbone that powers your regular Firefox browser tabs. And for privacy in your pocket, there's a whole new app. Firefox Focus brings all the punch of a Firefox private browsing tab onto your smartphone. Stop letting these trackers follow you around online and get your buns on over to the Firefox side of things. I promise, we only block the bad kind of cookies. So, you've gone dark on socials and you're harder to track online than ever using Firefox. But, what about sharing my email or phone number online? How can I keep those from leaking? Sometimes entering your contact info online is totally unavoidable. Maybe there's a 25% discount if you cough up that email. And yeah, at the time it was totally worth it for a novelty showerhead that looks like a duck from a sketchy Instagram store. But 2 weeks later, my spam box is jam-packed with all sorts of novelty bathroom accessories. Well, if you learn your lesson like me, let's avoid those sketchy shopping spam traps using Firefox Relay. This badass service will create a burner email address for you called an email mask that you can use instead of your real email address. Oh, and just when you thought it wasn't cool enough, Firefox Relay does phone numbers too. You can create a burner number just like the email service, and both calls and texts sent to the burner will forward to your number. Plus, if you're just waiting for that two-factor code to come in, you can enable or disable the number whenever you want. Aw, shucka ducky quack quack. That's all for this week's Ask Firefox. We know everything there is to know about all things internet, so drop your questions in the comments. Find us on Twitter and Instagram at Firefox. See you next time! Sweet taste of online privacy.